My story begins on January 31st, 1995. I was born at 8 pounds, 11 ounces, and brought back home to the most loving parents and the happiest big sister. Not much has changed since then, besides being less adorable, a little less chubby, and a lot less seductive. I was always hungry, just a little bit crazy, curious, animated, pretty weird, and always happy as can be. This is my mom. As a baby, I was known for giving stink eyes to anyone who dared steal her affection from me. My mother is the most beautiful woman in the world. She has taught me that true courage is not about being bold or loud, but really about saving your greatest strength for when it is most necessary. My mom is the most honest person I know, and I've yet to meet someone who is as stingy on herself, but overwhelmingly kind and generous to others as she is. Quite simply put, my mom has the heart of an angel, and as much as some people might make fun of her for wearing her Asian shield visor in public with me, I could never be embarrassed to be the daughter of such an incredible woman, however fobby she may be. She's the one person on this planet that I swear I love more than I do myself, and she will always be my best friend. When I was only 5 months old, my dad started panicking and told my mom, "What am I gonna do? She already doesn't like me." But really, it wasn't that way at all. Truth is, I love him in the most quiet, admiring way, but with all of my heart nonetheless. He is the bravest person I know. He gave me his courage and also his terrible temper. When I was little, I used to think that he was never really there for me because he worked from dawn till dusk. But as I grew up, it became more and more clear that he had worked endlessly for nothing more than my happiness. I'm his biggest fan, and I'm so proud to call myself his daughter. Papa, wo ai ni. This is my older sister, Carol, or as I call her, Sissy. She and I have taken turns being the big sister all our lives. We fought frequently, I won, but loved each other all the more. She taught me to have a tough skin, but also reminded me to be human and vulnerable. She was and always will be my fashion idol. I've watched her go through so much. I've watched her sell herself short so many times in her life. Right now, what I want more than anything is for her to be able to realize how much she is capable of and what she is worth. I have such big dreams for my sister, and I won't ever stop believing in her. Sissy, you are worth more than the world to me. You are lovely, and I will miss you so much. This is my Uncle Mark. He isn't really my uncle, but he might as well be. When I was little, he nicknamed me Happy Neck and treated me like a true princess. Uncle Mark is the reason why I love the outdoors. From bringing home little animals for me to call my own, and taking me grasshopper hunting all over town. He took me to so many beautiful places and taught me how to appreciate the little things in life that most people forget about. To me, he's just the most special person ever. When I grow up, I promise to take care of him just as he has taken care of me. His happiness is my motivation. Over the years, I underwent many transformations. From an adorable baby, to Lord knows what, to an Asian boy, and then there was 7th grade. Which brings us to the present. Shall I try to get it down? The past 4 years in ASB has shaped me into a better leader and person both in and out of the classroom. I've learned a lot about working with people and made some lifelong friends. Serving as ASB president has helped me learn the value of conviction and also of compromise. This has been the most rewarding experience for me, and I will miss my ASB family without a doubt.
Can I be close to you? Can I take it to a moment where the fields are painted gold and the trees are filled with memories of the feelings never told? When the evening pulls the sun down and the day is almost through, the whole world is sleeping, but my world is here. Can I be close to you? Can I be close to you?
I basically been living a sedentary lifestyle until hurdling came along and changed it all for me. My freshman year, the hurdling program transformed my self-confidence and constructed my character, and I was lucky enough to find my third family, the track team. The Link Crew ELD program is truly a blessing to me. It has made my high school experience so much more valuable. My favorite part of my life is the amazing people I'm blessed to be surrounded by each and every day. You guys are the reason why I love waking up each morning and why I feel motivated to make myself better each and every day. My friends have been among the most absurd forms of comical relief, the biggest sketchbags, the most sarcastic and sassy people, and then surprisingly enough, also the sweetest, most thoughtful, and most supportive individuals I've ever known. You guys are all destined to go off and do great things, and I'm so proud of you guys.
Can I be close to you?
Joshua Lanzona and I have been dating for 1.66 years now. Being 2,000 miles apart isn't easy, but I wouldn't go to 3 dances with my iPhone as a date for anyone else but him. He's crazy for loving me, but hey, I can't complain. Words like forever and never scare me and most everyone, but they don't scare him. I love him so much.
In the morning when I wake and the sun is...
Next year, I will be attending Harvard University in Cambridge, Massachusetts. I will be majoring in economics, and hopefully I will become a businesswoman/congresswoman/educator.